Hi everyone, I hope you're all doing well. Today I'm doing a plan with me on my Samsung tablet using a digital planning app for Android that my brother has made for me. So I've been slightly frustrated with the apps available for Android for digital planning, and whilst I love OneNote for its cross-platform abilities, I wanted something that worked more like Goodnotes on the iPad. My brother is super talented and he's made this app for me with digital planning in mind specifically. He's added in most of the features I wanted into the app, so I am really excited to start using this for planning on my Android tablet. I'm using a data planner here, so I'm just adding in the dates to the monthly page and dropping in some reminders. If anyone is interested in the app, just let me know in the comments. I'm accessing all of my stickers through the stickers panel, where I can import an entire folder of images at once because I really dislike having to import in stickers one by one as with most other apps. By the way, I'm loving this cute keyboard in the corner. I recently purchased a couple of these Bluetooth keyboards, so I'll be doing a review video on them soon. I like to use washi tape stickers for decorating my planner and for writing on reminders when I have something that spans over a couple of days. I wanted the ability to create my own hyperlinks, so here I'm just adding a hyperlink to another page in the planner, which is going to be my July overview. For my overview spread, I'm using these color block stickers to create different sections, and these stickers are available to download from our Freebies vault. With digital planning, I find it so much easier to be creative because I can just change the spread midway through and undo any mistakes. So with this particular spread, I didn't have a clear vision of what it was going to look like. I just started to put stuff down and see what looks good. For my monthly overview pages, I like to track my top priorities, to-do list, and goals, so I've created different boxes for them, and I'm using the highlighter pen to create some bullet points and lines. I really love the vintage look, so I've been using these vintage papers for decoration. If you Google bullet journal spreads, you will find lots of amazing examples that can give you inspiration. And here I'm just copying and pasting the overview hyperlink to my weekly pages as well, so that I can easily jump to the overview page from anywhere. And I'm also duplicating the overview spread before I start to fill it in, so that I can reuse it again for future months, as all I have to do is change the month and the calendar sticker. I've been trying to read more books recently, so I'm setting up a reading tracker. I'm making this page by starting out with a blank page and adding on the bookshelf sticker. On my monthly page, I'm creating a hyperlink to that bookshelf tracker by adding a hyperlink to a book sticker, and I'm pasting the sticker across to my weekly pages as well so that I can jump to my bookshelf quickly. If you like this video, subscribe to my channel and check out my other videos. Thanks for watching and see you again soon.